That was higher than my note. Oh, Kate. Hey guys, so it's been a while since I have done one of these, but I think it's time to start, get going again. I think I've thoroughly lived out my my break, and yeah, since the lockdown seems to be, you know, slowly lifting over here in the UK, which is great news for everyone. So, I mean, lockdown, I think it's been pretty much the same for everyone. You know, for me, I've been doing a lot of training, a lot of eating, which went well with the training. The training was definitely necessary at a certain point. And I think everyone's just been killing Netflix, really. I mean, on a rather sad note, I mean, I got back into watching The Crown recently again, just to kind of connect with, obviously, you know, the death of His Royal Highness Prince Philip, which is really sad. You know, very, very sad moment. You can imagine being with somebody for as long as the Queen has been with Philip, but you can't really imagine it, can you? It's wild. So I've been trying to work on something for that, actually, but I'll let you know about that in a later date. Music, I don't know, I've been dotting around with music. I kind of went through a little bit of a rock phase, I think, for a bit. I mean, Spotify has you jumping around on some strange things. But yeah, most of that, I've just been relaxing, enjoying this couple of months that I've had off after, you know, all the live streaming last year, which was a very hectic and fun time. I mean, you know, most of all through this lockdown, it's been difficult to see Bear at certain points, but I've actually connected with my son a lot more, which is fantastic. I've definitely been enjoying not being too far away from them, which has been great. And he's just growing at such a speedy rate, as children do, really. It's crazy to watch it. He had a great birthday, which I went down to, which was fantastic. Yeah, it's been great. Another thing I've been doing recently, which was a really random one for me, actually, was the FIFA Play On podcast, it turned out fantastic. I was a bit nervous to start off with, actually, how this was going to go. I mean, I suppose it's a lot like this is, really. And I mean, this, I like doing these, but it does feel very strange being sat in a room talking to yourself. It's the closest sign to insanity I think one could be. Yeah, we did some fantastic ones. It was great, actually. I recently caught back up with French Montana, which I haven't spoken to since we did first time, actually, which is really great. But if you go and check them out, I mean, they're it's about football, music related to football, the way the footballers feel, the way footballers act, the way, you know, it was amazing, and to meet so many great talents in such a short space of time, I felt very fortunate. So thank you very much, FIFA, for having me on for that one. But please go and check them out on your streaming platform. I'm looking at some tweets here, it would seem. At Weekend for Waffa, Liam Payne, first artist to have a virtual reality performance, first to host digital signing, global event, first to use donations to and raise money, world's first to do live AR performance. That's a lot of firsts in my month. A lot of firsts. Well, I didn't actually know there was that many firsts. Hashtag Liam making history. And we were the first boy band to ever get number one, so I mean, so the first performance that I've done this year, I believe it's the first performance. I mean, all the days are kind of rolling into one at this point. It was really strange performing after so long not being on stage. But the most strange thing I could say about it, really, was, I mean, I was in a thing called a mocap suit. And a mocap suit consists of, it looks like a diving suit that's not waterproof, and then they put loads of dots on you. And I had a phone that was strapped to my head, so it didn't really make for a very easy performance for the first one back. I was very embarrassed walking in that suit, especially after all of the lockdown eating that I've been doing. but it was fun, you know. Once again, world first. What can you say? It was. It took them 3 months to make another me. and I mean, that was it. Really, wasn't it? It was me performing with me, which also was quite strange, but we love it. It was awesome. But I enjoyed the performance more. It was nice to be back in a suit, actually, but it was more to do with the way the performance was crafted and having to be in certain places, certain times, and do certain things. And yeah, it was a lot of fun. And thanks to all the team at BAFTA and BBC for having me along for that, for both performances. If you haven't seen that yet, you should go and check out the Round app. You can have a photo with virtual me, which my friend Luke had aptly nicknamed Kelvin. I don't know why. Yes, so go and check it out. See what you think. I mean, another thing that's been the best thing in lockdown for me really has been art. And I've been struggling for months to paint at all, to be honest with you. No, I moved house and it seemed like I left my painting stuff back at the other house, if that makes sense. So, I mean, I got really into it the other night, so much so that I didn't go to sleep for a very long time. Which is the special one I was talking to you about, which I haven't quite decided what I'm going to do with it yet. But yeah, this is just a short little video of some of the stuff that I've been up to, so you can have a little look around. I got into painting a lot of rats for some reason. I don't know. I like rats because people don't like them. There's my nephew, some skull. Seems to be painting a lot of death. You can see there's a Grim Reaper in the background as well. Is there supposed to be sound with this? Oh no, there isn't any sound. It's supposed to be just me talking, I'm guessing. And then that last one's going to be a very special thing, which brings me to this next slide. How do I get into NFTs? NFTs, I mean, a lot of people don't really know what NFTs are. They're non-fungible tokens. And it's been a really great way for people to token art online, which seems bizarre in some circumstances, but there's some amazing pieces that are out there. But yeah, I mean, I've always been quite a collector of stuff. I like collecting things, and I guess this is just another means to that in a way, really. There's a guy called Beeple who even got, put on a, was it Sotheby's or Christie's, I think it was, which is amazing. And for these people who make these 3D things, which, by the way, are really, really tough and hard to make, because it seems strange that people would spend so much money on a 15-second clip, but these things take a lot of effort, a lot of work. So, I mean, the creators on there are absolutely awesome. And we bought a few of them, me and my team, which have been quite good. Yeah, I mean, just to explain the NFT thing a little bit more as well, because I want you guys to understand before I go on to my next bit, really. It seems weird because you could screenshot it, you could take a photo, but you'll never have the original file of the piece of what it is, and that's how this works. I mean, we live in such a technological age these days, and things are moving so quickly all the time. It's, you know, something on the computer sometimes that has to be worth something, and this is how that they've figured this out. Blockchain technology, which I'm sure you've all heard of, with bitcoins and everybody going on about those for a long time. What else has been great, actually, is I've reconnected with Zed through this as well. So a lot of my old friends that I've made songs with now, I've been reconnecting with, which has been really, really awesome. Zed and Gabe actually did a release on there, so you should go and check that out on Zed's page. And Gabe originally was designing on Zed's tour. And if you want to check all these out, you should go and head over to Nifty Gallery is the one that I have been looking at the most. But there's some good stuff on there. So I'm hoping, yeah, there's something in that art book that I'm hoping to bring to the table very soon. But at the right time, we'll see how it all goes. What the hell is going past? Never mind. Yeah, there's something I'm hoping to do on Nifty very soon. We'll see how that goes. But here's like a little short shot of these things so that you can get to know and understand them a little better. There's good old Gabe. Nifty Gateway. I'll put all the info for all of this in the bottom of my... See, it's crazy how much money people are spending on these things. But it is phenomenal. Sustainability. Sustainability, you know, it's something that we all hear very much these days. And, I mean, I have to admit, I hadn't given it as much thought as I should have. And then, obviously, Netflix, I watched Seaspiracy and was deeply disturbed by what I was watching. I mean, it's difficult to pick the truth out of any of these things these days because, you know, you never know where, there's so much news out there these days that you never really know which one to listen to. And then after that, I watched What the Health, and then that freaked me out as well. So, I mean, it all kind of freaked me out. So I'm deciding to try and do some more sustainable things. I've got to change a lot of things about myself. But I think, you know, that's the point of it, really. You know, you look at yourself as such a small object in the world, really. But the idea of all of us moving together, even slowly but surely, is better than not moving at all. And it, you know, we have to. I watched David Attenborough's Netflix thing as well, and it's all quite disturbing, really. And if you stop to think about it too long, it's scary. Yeah, we're going to start to move in a more sustainable way here at Liam Payne Industries, or whatever the hell I'm known for anymore. Here is a show reaction video found online. Right from the final act, nice. We made a start. Hi, Annika. Be it a false one, I know. Like, yes, turn it up. We took a chance. This is great. I love this. You by oh, little replay. Replay. That was higher than my note. Oh. Ah, awesome! That's a nice way to end this video. Actually, thank you, Connor, for throwing that on in there for me to have a look at. That's made me a little bit emotional. So I mean, it's not the end of the video. Actually, that was a lie, because we are trying something new this year with the live streams. Obviously, to make shows at the rate we were making them was a big, big task. And I think I'm going to go in a slightly different direction with this. I'm hold the pun. So, I mean, stay tuned for that. Stay tuned for a lot of things, really. But it's really great to be back doing this all with you. I had some good time off, but I'm ready to come back and do some more things with you guys and for you guys. So, thank you very much.